Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video we are going to learn about necessary equipment and methodology to capture macro images like these photos. Hope you will find decent very good color combination with a satisfying background in maximum of them. So let's get started to the various tips and tricks or methods of macro photography. Now comes to our first point. Rather than body, lens matters. Here, all the images are captured with a 10-year-old Nikon D3100. In first, best and expensive equipment is macro lens. There are various types of macro lenses are available in the market, which are very fast and very easy to focus. In second, extension tubes. Kindly choose those extension tubes which have autofocus feature. This is one of the finest and cheapest method in the market. Here, maximum of the images are captured with Nikkor 50mm 1.8G coupled with an extension tube. Lens reversal ring in third. This is the cheapest method to capture macro photographs. Taking pictures by this is little difficult, but after mastering it, we can get very good results. Please keep in mind, here focusing system is completely manual. In point number 2, diffusers and external lights. Using a paper like this is a great idea. But for better images, please use external flashes with diffusers. Even you can use multiple flashes through remote connectivity. Point number 3. Use a tripod. Stability is the key of success. A stable camera will always help to capture stunning images in the macro world. Point number 4. Good background, good macro. Please always search for different color background which creates a good effect in maximum cases. Many people don't think about the background, but if we look for a good colorful background, great results will be the output like this. Point number 5. More color, more beautiful. But that doesn't mean monochromes are bad. They are good too. Sometimes good images are not looks good because of the natural color. So kindly play with the color, especially in Lightroom, where many features are available to recreate it. So until or unless you are satisfied, kindly change according to your requirement. Point number 6. Area of focus versus depth of field. Depth of field is the main enemy in case of macro photography. But once you learn to accommodate your desired area of focus into the depth of field, the outputs are awesome. Always try to focus on the edges or at the centers, which are the main area of attraction. If you are shooting a flower, try to capture from that area where you can get maximum area. If you are shooting any insects or dolls or anything have eyes, please focus on their eyes. The main tip is that try to find a flat surface or a small narrow object which are easy to focus. Many photographers use image focus technique for better macros. I will cover this topic on another video. Point number 7. Massive bokeh. Massive bokeh is proportional to the distance of background. Try to capture images by keeping a good distance from the background, which will create a great bokeh effect and the main center of attraction will be highlighted greatly. Capturing subject, keeping the background in the same plane is obviously not a great idea. Again, I am telling you that better isolation from the background creates a better image. Point number 8. Adequate lighting. Sometimes sunlight on direct subject will help us to capture images through narrow lens opening, but sometimes it becomes hard to ruin your best shot. So for better images or for the soft vivid color, try to capture the images under shade or under shadow. Please keep in mind that it is not difficult to shed a tiny object by your hand or any other things or by your own shadow of your body. Point number 9. Color or background isolation. In many cases, you didn't like the image just because of the bad background. So just isolate the background by turning into a monochrome. And in 90% cases, your mind will be changed. This edit always emphasizes the subject and make them very highlighted. You can easily done the same by using Lightroom. Just check the image. Isolation doesn't mean turning into a black and white only. Try dark backgrounds or different colors or create different contrast to highlight the subject. The last point, virtual background. This is the most interesting thing or deep secret in macro photography. Use your laptop, tablet or mobile phone and download the desired background and adjust the brightness to looks like a natural. The results are like this. Here, brightness of the screen plays a great role in it, so adjust the same accordingly. So guys, if you find this video very interesting and helpful to you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you guys.